Hey guys, what's up? Brian Vega here today. Today I wanted to discuss iPhone OS 4.0. Now, we've known a few details about iPhone OS 4.0 since April, I believe, beginning of April when Apple decided to announce these, a few features that we might be seeing in the firmware update this June. So, I'll go ahead and tell you those, but we've also discovered a couple other features that they did not let us know in that announcement, and I wanted to share those as well in the beta versions. That way we can get a little bit more of a clear view of what we might see this summer. So right now we've already got multitasking. They've announced that this firmware is going to be compatible with the iPhone 3G, iPhone 3GS, iPod Touch 2G, and iPod Touch 3G. The newer devices, of course, will support this, but sorry to the iPhone original, the first or second generation, whatever you want to call it, or the iPod Touch first generation, you will not be able to even update to this firmware. But for multitasking, it's only going to work with the iPhone 3GS and the iPod Touch 3G. So 2G and 3G, iPhone and iPod Touch, you will be able to update, you just won't have this multitasking feature. Now, the multitasking feature basically allows you to type an email, go to Safari, come back and continue typing that email. As an example, right now your iPod and iPhone already does multitasking with the iPod Music. You can listen to music and browse other apps or Safari or check your email. Basically, you'll be able to do that except with every app, which is kind of nice. Another feature that was announced is folders. We've known this, we haven't known this, but we've used this feature before. If you've jailbroken your device, we had the ability to store applications in a folder. We could title the folder whatever we want and put all the apps in there. So we open up the folder and the apps are all listed there, organized. So basically it's a nice organization method. It's optional, you know, it's there if you want to use it now. In this new firmware. Another feature is better email. It'll have a unified inbox where you will be able to check multiple emails all in one inbox instead of, you know, going back, you know, let's check this email, then we have to go back and check the other email. Instead, it'll all be in one inbox, you know, where you can reply to several from different accounts, which is a nice thing. According to Apple.com, we will also see iBooks on the iPhone and iPod Touch on this new firmware. And right now it's already on the iPad 3.2 firmware. We are on 3.1.3 iPhone and iPod Touch people right now. iBook basically is exactly the same as on the iPad, except it'll be a smaller view, obviously. You know, we get an iBook store. I believe that is what it is going to be. They don't really offer that much detail on iBook, but you know, I think we could pretty much compare that to what it's like right now on the iPad. So now I want to talk to you about a couple other features. Now I'm gonna have to look at my notes for this, so if I look up like this, you know, I'm looking at a little TV screen where I got my computer hooked up to, but you know, I just want to get these details to you. What's new in iPhone OS 4.0 that I didn't just say, that Apple did not originally announce? Some cool features. You know, we got a special widget where we will be able to, you know, click play and pause music directly from the home screen, in the dock area, actually, to be specific. This is confirmed, you know, in the beta version, they could always take it out. So, it is usable. Basically, the dock, you know, you'll be able to slide over. You got a play button, you got a next, you got a previous, you got the actual iPod button to go to that, to the iPod app, and you got an orientation lock. Basically, this means I don't have my iPod Touch anymore, as you know, but I'll just use this as an example. You know, you got your phone, and you turn it sideways. If you have orientation lock on, all you're going to see is the screen right side up. You know, it's going to be like this, even though it's sideways. If the orientation is like it always is, you know, you'll be able to turn it sideways, everything will go sideways, you know. This is helpful if you're, like, laying down and, you know, whatever at the same time. And you know, we've all had that experience where we're trying to do something and all of a sudden it decides to flip on us. Orientation lock fixes that, which is a really nice feature. And by the way, the reason the play buttons were moved to the widget, because you know, you double-click the home button on the device, you'd get the music. Well, that has double-clicking the home button now does multitasking. So they moved that to the dock. And multitasking, double-clicking on the home button will now bring up the multitasking screen on iPhone OS 4.0. That's basically all on that area. We've got some rumors about Facebook being integrated to the iPhone OS 4.0, but that's kind of unlikely in my opinion. You know, it's not, doesn't really sound like something Apple would do. So I have my doubts on that, but you know, we can only hope. Some social network integration would be nice for the iPhone. And iPod Touch, you know, if it's available. So, some more features, you know. Messaging. Right now, they have put a new settings thing for messaging where you will be able to enable or disable MMS messaging, group messaging, you know, several different things. Not much settings, but we also got a much faster Google Maps. It seems more smooth, according to the person who used the firmware. Obviously, by the way, I didn't mention this before, but you will be getting home screen wallpaper. So, those of you on your regular phone who already have a nice little wallpaper, well, guess what? That advanced iPhone will be getting that. And this is available for all compatible iPhone OS for devices. And obviously, the new devices will. You'll know what I'm talking about. New devices in the next video. I will discuss those in the next video. Some more features. We see in the settings screen to set up internet tethering, which shows that Apple wants to get into that. AT&T just a couple weeks ago said they still weren't ready. Their network isn't good enough for it yet. But you know, Apple's getting ready for it. We can only hope tethering comes to that device because it's a nice feature. If it doesn't, you know, there's always a workaround, I believe, to get tethering for free, you know. Other than orientation, you know, you'll be able to turn your entire photo roll in a different orientation. That's not a big deal with that. But that is about all I have to discuss for iPhone firmware. The firmware sounds great. If it's as good as it sounds, I actually hope they do bring into it is some kind of widget, kind of like Android does, you know, being able to view your weather right on the home screen and Facebook updates and Twitter updates, and you know, those things are useful. You're kind of ordinary on a lot of smartphones today, so instead of having icons, you know, that you have to push to get that information, it would be nice if we can get widgets. So, that's what I hope is in the firmware, and I just discussed what is in the firmware so far. Keep in mind, these are betas. Anything could change. You know, it could completely change. They could completely remove it. It's mainly for developers right now. I would, actually, have the iPhone firmware on my device. I was going to actually put it on, but then I found out that you have to have a Mac, first of all. They're only letting you update to it on a Mac right now. Because you have to have a Mac to be a developer. And you also have to have a developer account, which costs $100 a year. And I decided I don't have a Mac. You know, I don't have a developer account. I can't do it this year. I did do it last year, though, 3.0 beta. So, and another setback, iPod Touch washed. So, you know. That's why I'll be getting the iPhone this year. More details about the new iPhone in the next video. Keep up to date. Make sure you subscribe and also like the video below. And post any comments. You know, let me know what you think about this possible new firmware. Thanks for watching.